Oi oi, it's Fish here. Welcome to another episode of King Fishtail. So today we're going to be pulling the front end off this XT Falcon. I'm going to be showing you the different tools that I use along the way. Some that work well, some that don't work at all. I'm just going to be figuring it out as I go. Obviously, as it's my first time ever doing it. So if you're interested in seeing a pretty like kind of more in-depth sort of process of how to go about it, because I've never pulled apart or really actually studied to see how they configure a car from factory regarding all the way that they weld it and that sort of thing. So gonna, yeah, might be able to learn some things by watching through my mistakes or through my successes. Yeah, sit tight, hope you enjoy it. G'day, Cyclops here. Just trying to remove this brake booster from this Falcon. I'll get rid of this. Okay, now I'm in the process of trying to figure out how to remove the GoPro. There we go. I'm just trying to get this out of the road because I'm trying to get this firewall, as all of this is I've drilled out and it's nowhere near at all flimsy, like it's still solid as. So I'm trying to just detach as much as I can off this back firewalls and then just see it a little bit better. No doubt if I pull this apart, it's going to fill everywhere. Yeah. Might drain that. Moved at least. Just need it. Maybe if I just like undo the lines and then put them up. Actually, no, then that will drain. So I just pulled the brake booster off and pulled off this, I don't know, thermal shield kind of thing. And you can see where I've already pulled apart both them. Started to drill that apart, but I think where we're getting stuck here now is this. Do you want to go through maybe? Because I probably could just cut this and then like when I got the, because this will still be on the other FG. We can re-weld it on there, maybe.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Do you have time to talk about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? Hey, don't run from the Lord!
Just don't understand.
Let's pull this out. Pretty cool.
It like goes right way back up in there.
Maybe my best bet is to just unstitch it from here.
I've done this one. It's kind of buggered, but good enough for a drift car. And then I can maybe just get this section here off and then leave all this on. Saves digging around with all this because it just goes too far back.
I think that's what the plan is. Yep.
New plan. Otherwise, I'm just going to have to pull off way too much. And I can get to all that heaps easier. Shit, yeah. Righto, let's get the drill out.
Oops.
Supposed to be able to feel where it goes through half the sheet metal, but sometimes that's just not the case.
So I don't know if you can see, but the angle where these spot drill bit spot welds are is a bit shit. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have seen people use this thing before, but we'll give it a go. Don't really know how I'm supposed to drill through 1.5 mil of steel with this,
I think it just exposes it rather than actually drills it out, but whatever. Well, now I've kind of lost the spot welds. Can't even see as well.
You know what else sometimes you can do? It's just... just get it. Oh yeah. Cause I don't care if I ruin this. I want to keep this one a bit pretty, but if I can just ruin one bit of steel, that's all right. I was planning on trying to take out this windshield because I thought I was going to be taking all this back and I just would have no room to get it out, but
doing this part here, then I don't have to take the windshield out. And even if I break it, then it doesn't really matter. Kind of getting somewhere. You can slowly see more and more. It's just so annoying because obviously I haven't designed this for it to come apart. They've got half the body coming in and then they'll have half of the outer coming in and then they've got the inner and then that's all like layered different ways and then you come onto the outside and then it's gone the opposite way, so I don't know how they've kind of all gelled it and yeah, it's pretty tricky to try and pull it apart. It'd be a lot easier if I just cut it really, but even though it looks all bucket and ugly now, I will, bit of love with the hammer, bash it back nice and straight.
Hello?
You probably won't want to eat it, but I've been looking for you to know about sausage rolls. I'm over taste, babe. I grilled and I'm paying for it. Thanks, bud. Making progress. Making progress.
That's good.
Ooh. See, this is what I mean by how they have it all coming in. So they got the outer frame of the tub, and then they got this weird fin, and then they've got this inside panel going in there as well, so it all has three different sections all going in, or four, and then it has this top one which I've half disassembled, and so then this one which is the inner artwell, it goes in there as well, and you kind of like get a bit lost when it's obviously all the same color and you're trying to find out what panel's doing what, and you look it from one side and then you try and see it on the other side, but then it has another panel, another like bit of sheet metal going in there, so you kind of lose where you're at and lose what panel's what, but getting there. Probably should have had this set out a little while ago. Oh yeah, beautiful. Thank you. Giving me my chisel back, Falcon. Holy shit. So yeah, apparently I just don't really care about my tools very much. One side of the car is off. That's actually sick. That's off. And so you can see obviously a bit of my butchering skills, but that will not take nothing at all. Hammer them all back flat, and obviously drift car. That's gonna be my new saying for this whole build. Yeah, just drift car though.
is all off. So on that one, now that I've
had a bit of a practice run with this one, with materials that don't really matter, I'll be able to be a bit more surgical with, now that I know how it all goes together. And well, I don't know, but I have a bit of an idea.
I always see like everyone, they just do like center punches to get the center of the holes. But if you actually just half decent, like actually getting it center, it works out fine. And then the edge chisel gets the rest of it. So that's working well for me so far. Obviously it wouldn't, that's not what you really want if you're working in a shop or something, I suppose. Like if it's gonna be some high quality finished car.
So then I just repeated the same process on the other side of the car. Obviously it wasn't identical, as they have different mounting brackets and that sort of thing from one side to the other, but it was pretty much the same sort of concept. Just started drilling away, and seeing as I'd already done one side, it was a lot easier to actually pull apart and know what I needed to do, and kind of know the general way that it was constructed from the factory. Check out how rusty these old forts are. That's in between the two panels. And when I say old, this is what, a 2008 or 2009 model probably?
Which is, that's pretty sad time to be in, like where we're getting it. Like shows how old I'm getting and how old we're all getting, is that that's like considered now old. Like in that F6, that's 2010, 14 years old now. It's not good. Now they're going to get all like slowly coming into electric cars, and
I wonder how much rust mine has in there as well. Hopefully I like to think a lot less, because it's always been kept undercover a bit. So I've almost got the front clip off, I think, like on that stuff. There probably might be a few little places here and there that...
See that? Both sides are almost off. So, I don't actually know what the best go is. I might be able to just lower it all the way to the ground and then get a jack up underneath here. Because I think it still might be a little bit heavy. Might be weighing like maybe 50, 60 kilos or something. I do have a forklift.
I don't really want to bend it. Shit. Put my gloves on before I cut something off. Not supposed to come off. Such as my thumb.
So, I think I might just go back to what I used to do before I had a forklift or anything, and just put my back at risk of dislocating or whatever it's called.
Oh, it's still bloody attached. One last little spot weld.
Pretty happy with that.
So now I just need to unstitch this, because I want this
front crossmember. So then I can be able to, I'll be able to put this to the side, and then I'll be able to see the width, because I'll be able to just put this front crossmember up to the other one, which is a little bit bent, and then I'll just be able to know how far I need to pull in the front chassis rail, that sort of thing. This is going to get pulled back in. Like, if I do similar sort of damage on the other one, I'll be able to make that all go back together, kind of thing. But obviously, on this car here, I was trying to keep the actual front, I don't know what you call that, front clip, keep that in better condition than what this is, because I can blow this one back. Whereas on the other one, when I go to put this one back together, I'm going to destroy more so the front section and keep the rear section in better condition. So, and then I put the new one on,
bada bing, bada boom, and then we go sliding after a lot of other things we need to do, you know, before we actually go sliding, but such as pull the engine out, put it back in, put the gearbox in, and then I have to put the F6 on the hoist, I have to pull the exhaust off the hoist, I have to pull the clutch out of the hoist. It's going to be a pretty decent process, I think. A lot of work to do. I think I'm going to pull the
rear cradle out of this as well, because at some stage I might want to try and morph the rear end of this into that.
So it's got independent rear suspension rather than leaf suspension. I don't really know now what to do other than pull off this front crossmember and drop the rear cradle. We kind of have the chassis rail going in, and then they got the crossmember there, and then they've got a cover plate that goes on the outside all the way to the inside, so it's all kind of sandwiched in together. It's not as simple as I thought, unless I just drill the face straight off it. We'll just go straight on the front, then I'll be able to know which way left and right to pull the chassis. Obviously it's got to come in because it's bent out, but I might just pull off these tabs here as well, because on the other one they're all buggered. They're all, looks like an octopus is trying to come out the front. It's got all these different fingers going everywhere.
Just like that.
My other one, it kind of looks like this. But
okay, I come up with a new plan. I don't think I'm going to drop the rear cradle out of this anymore. It's pretty beat up.
Like, you see this? It's with the sway bar. It literally just oozed its way through the top of that.
And I figured by the time I actually get this car back together, I want to get out there and actually start driving it. So I don't think that having this diff here and this rear cradle is gonna actually be, it'll just be sitting around for so long before I actually need to do it, because I'll still slide that for quite a while and actually get used to it, and I've got a lot of other mods I want to do to it first before I worry about doing the rear cradle. And that way then the rear cradle will just be sitting around here taking up space. So, and they're only $250 online. I just looked at Marketplace just then to get an XR6 one. And I don't actually know the internal differences between obviously there's the LSD versions and that sort of stuff, but I don't know what other differences there are between the axles and that sort of thing. So I assume that the XR6 ones would be better in many ways, but and who knows, I probably will go even bigger and better than an XR6 one. Maybe I might go true track or something like that. So I think I'm just gonna leave this in there. So that'll probably do it for this episode. I think it's pretty good, little mission accomplished. Little thing to tick off the list is getting the whole front clip off. So for the next episode, I'd probably like to get maybe the front two doors off just to keep them as spares. I might even just throw the driver's side door on the actual XR6 turbo to begin with, because the one on the turbo is a little bit dinted up and that sort of thing. And then, I ideally want to get rid of the actual XT Falcon so I can clear up some space here. Maybe get the other XR6 turbo onto the hoist and start maybe getting the engine dropped out of that, or start assessing what needs to be done and pulling that apart. It's going to be, yeah, a very long process because I can't actually fully get it back together because I need the clutch out of the F6, I need the exhaust out of the F6. So I kind of need them to actually get the car running. But I think I might just try and get it all together and then just get it running, because I'm going to have to figure out all the wiring and that sort of stuff, because that's going to be an absolute mission, as that's something I've never done, and it's going to be like so temperamental, I think. But all big learning curve, that's for sure. So yeah, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and just comment down below if you've got any ideas what you think I should do, or how I can do it better, or what you'd like to see. Then yeah, let me know. Yeah, I'll see you next time. Thanks.